From Studio 1A in Tampa, Florida, comes a talk show that really feels your pain and tells you like it is. We love America and all that freedom-loving Americans want to protect. Live from coast to coast and on your radio, it's For the People with Keith Allen.
We'll help you survive this thing called life. We're for the people, whatever your source of stress or strife. For the people is there.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. America. I am Keith Allen and proudly welcoming you into this Friday's edition of For the People on a November the 10th, 2017. We got a big show lined up for you. Can you expect anything less? It is your daily infusion of common sense. So feel the news with the clarity just coming over you right now. Floodgates just opening up because of the fake news that's out there. President Donald Trump praising China's president, Jinping. Jinping is a highly respected and a powerful representative of his people, while slamming previous White House administrations for the nation's huge trade deficit with Beijing. And Trump, of course, took to Twitter. I mean, it still works there in China. He says, my meetings with President Xi Jinping were very productive on both trade and the subject of North Korea. Xi is highly respected and powerful. He's a representative of his people. It was great being with him. And Madam Ping, he says, I don't blame China. He says, I blame the incompetence of past administrations for allowing China to take advantage of the U.S. on trade, leading up to a point where the U.S. is losing hundreds of billions of dollars. How can you blame China for taking advantage of people that had no clue? I wouldn't have done the same. And there was a big, big, huge applause there. They did not take that. They were saying, hey, if you idiots did this, if you allowed us to do this and to continue doing with the trade things, nobody was a smart CFO, CEO that knew how to deal with money. And now Trump has a administration that actually is on this and understands that Trump knew this stuff going in about the disparity with the hundreds of billions of dollars that we're losing every year because of it. Who's looking out for who? Everybody says, oh, Donald Trump's looking out for his own pocketbook that was on the left. Oh, he's concerned with how much money he's making. He's looking out for you and I. Oh, but Donald Trump, he's looking out for him. That's it. Yeah, what about his businesses? What about the hotel? Who cares about it? He built the hotel. He built an empire. Now he's building us up. My goodness gracious, the left has nothing better to say. They get nothing to say. I mean, it would be as ludicrous to say that Donald Trump's company is not his any longer. They were taking the Trump off all the buildings because we can't have his T's on there. They're just so mad that the Trump organization still goes on and makes money. They're just furious about this. But you don't think that CNN... Or anybody like that is going to be running this. This is Donald Trump in China talking about these very things.
And this relationship is something which we are working very hard to make a fair and a reciprocal one. Trade between China and the United States has not been, over the last many, many years, a very fair one for us. As we all know, America has a huge annual trade deficit with China, a number beyond anything what anybody would understand. This number is shockingly hundreds of billions of dollars each year. Estimates are as high as $500 billion a year. We must immediately address the unfair trade practices that drive this deficit, along with barriers to market success. We really have to look at access, forced technology transfer, and the theft of intellectual property, which just by and of itself is costing the United States and its companies at least $300 billion a year. Both the United States and China will have a more prosperous future if we can achieve a level economic playing field. Right now, unfortunately, It is a very one-sided and unfair one. But I don't blame China. After all, who can blame a country for being able to take advantage of another country for the benefit of its citizens? I give China great credit. But in actuality, I do blame past administrations for allowing this out-of-control trade deficit to take place and to grow. We have to fix this because it just doesn't work.
And it's not working. And he points it out, and he wasn't booed. They know that they were doing this. Trump knows that they were doing this. Steve Bannon knows. His people know. But do you think the left is going to say anything about the trade deficit? You think they're going to say anything about that? We don't ought to upset the Chinese because we don't want a trade war. We can't do this. God forbid our Chinese food is going to go up. It's so cheap over here, and then the items are so cheap over there that it's going to go up, and that's not going to work anymore. Everybody's so paranoid. The left on that. Forget about the money that we've lost or have been losing. It doesn't matter to them. They don't even want to see it. You put it right in front of them. They still don't want to listen. It just pains them. The left pains them to say anything well of this president. I heard one say earlier, it's so tough to be Donald Trump. He reads off a teleprompter. Donald Trump didn't read off the teleprompter. Bill Clinton didn't read on teleprompter. George W. didn't read. H. Bush didn't run off one. Ronald Reagan didn't read off a teleprompter. They all read off a teleprompter so they could stay on point, so they could have an eloquent speech, one that has all the particulars in it so you don't forget something. It's nice we can go off the cuff, and we know what Donald Trump does off the cuff, that this is a very important trip. You should be happy that Donald Trump is on the teleprompter. It was the left that was saying, if only Donald Trump would stay on there, it's just when he goes off the teleprompter, then it goes haywire. They should be praising his efforts for doing this and not going off the script. That he actually appears to be extremely presidential and diplomatic. This is a good thing. But they can't see it this way. Of course not. Of course not. I applaud the trip. President Trump and President Xi Jinping announced $250 billion investments. Deals been made. Here's the deal maker. Where's that song? Money, 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 money. $250 billion. These are tentative agreements now. Which came in the form of tentative agreements. Trump also said earlier in his visit with the president of China that very good chemistry. The chemistry worked out, but he did attack Beijing's predatory trade practices before he ripped previous American administrations. The trade relationship between China and the U.S. has been a very fair one. As we all know, America has a huge annual trade deficit with China, a number beyond anything that anyone would understand, Trump said. Both the United States and China will have a more prosperous future if we can achieve a more level playing field. And that's a good thing for the United States regarding previous U.S. leaders. The president said, after all, who can blame a country for being able to take advantage of another country for the benefit of its citizens? We've been getting screwed. China's been getting rich. How do you think they afford what they're doing all this? Do you see Beijing? Do you see the cities over there, what they have built? Their infrastructure is unbelievable. What do you think a lot of that money came from? You. You buy the goods. You consume the goods. You love the goods. But there is a huge trade war that's been going. They declared war on us a long time ago to suck out as much as they possibly can for their own greed. But we let them do it. And Trump's saying, I'm a CEO. I'm a CFO. Daddy's home. We got somebody in the White House that's going to be looking out for you. Who's looking out for you? I feel the love. I feel that Trump is going to be bringing back much more money to our economy. That's going to help every one of us so we can have more money in our pockets. And guess what? We could actually raise the prices, too. So we're actually making more money. Let's make it fair. Fair trade. It hasn't been fair. And what did Ross Perot say back in the 90s? Free trade ain't free. He was right. Here's a guy who knew economics too, and ran with Pat Schoed, an economist that knew what time it was too. They both were beating the drum back in the early 90s. Now, finally, Trump's doing something about it. This many years, it took that long. But finally, we got somebody making good deals for us. And folks, I think it's a good day for America. Take a nice big breath. Take it all in. I feel like this is a time where America can get on its right financial path and destiny to start rebuilding its cities and infrastructure so we can start being competitive around the world, because we are not. Think about the competitiveness of the space race. We got there, we did it, and then we just stopped doing things. We lead in other areas, and that's great, but there's so many other countries out there in the world besides us that are superseding us. So American exceptionalism, as Donald Trump would, or excuse me, Barack Obama would tout and say that we did all these things, but it wasn't necessary. Let other people lead. America used to lead, and now we're leading again. Somebody has to lead that has these values, that has some smarts, that can steer. And I think what Trump was trying to say to the Chinese is that we can learn something from them. That, you know, the predatory, you know, when you're in business, you suck out as much money as you could possibly suck out within reason. But he did it in front of everybody. And nobody complained. This kept on buying the goods. I guarantee there will be better deals. This is a beautiful day for America. I just want to say, God bless America. Just do it right now. Just crank it up on your your computers or on your radio. But it's a beautiful thing. It's a good Trump day in China. That's for sure. And they all laughed. You heard it right there in that sound clip. It was beautiful. Senate candidate Roy Moore's campaign is damage control now, because they're calling the allegations of these sexual misconduct charges, saying that it's fake news and intentional defamation. The campaign released a statement yesterday, as the Washington Post reported, the Alabama Republican candidate had sexual contact with one teenager and pursued three others nearly four decades ago. The campaign says Judge Roy Moore has endured the most outlandish attacks on any campaign in the modern political arena, but this story in today's Washington Post, alleged sexual perpetuity, takes the cake. He says the statement also notes that Moore had been married to the same woman for 33 years. And has four children and five grandchildren. It continues, after over 40 years of public service, if any of these allegations were true, they would have been made public long before now. Moore used the allegations to appeal for donations in a fundraising email. So in the fundraising plea, Moore said, the Obama, Clinton, machetes out there, the liberal media lapdogs just launched the most vicious and nasty round of attacks against me I have ever faced. Moore says he refuses to repeat their lies, and he is counting on the help of God-fearing conservatives like you to stand with me at this critical moment. The Obama Clinton machine, liberal media lapdogs, that's what he calls them. The force of evil will lie, cheat, steal, even inflict physical